Bulawayo.
Unzonkulu.
Weposo.
Weposo.
Haile
Daye.
Trials for our residents and particularly people living in rural areas. I had occasion this past weekend to spend some time in Gulati communal land, and I was profoundly shocked. I'm sure all of you have been visiting Ikaya, and you know the situation for yourself. I was profoundly shocked because even small dams that I have seen in the past, which had water in September, October, are already completely dry. We know from traditional leaders living in those areas that there has been no grain harvested this year. No maize, no sorghum, no millet. Cattle are dying. People are really selling their cattle in great numbers, and the price of cattle is plummeting. And our city is not immune from this, as we will discuss in this meeting. Our dams are sitting at alarmingly low levels, something like 35%. And so we face a real crisis in this region, throughout this country, but particularly as leaders, we face a great crisis at present. I'm pleased to report that the government has responded to our short-term needs, as you know, with the promise of some 40 million. And since we last met, the Minister of Finance has availed the council of 1.5 million, and our engineering department are working hard to ensure that that money is allocated to our priorities. And I take this opportunity to call on the Minister of Finance to please disperse the balance of that money, some 13 million US dollars. We need that money urgently. We have to reconfigure pipelines from Encisa and in Chavez. This is work that cannot be done overnight, cannot even be done within weeks. There are major engineering works required. I'm advised by our engineering department that Lower Nema, Upper Nema will be decommissioned within the coming months. That places an even greater strain on our water reticulation and pumping works with those dams, given their proximity to the Nema water pump stations. And so we are going to need water from Mseza and Mchabesi urgently, and we can only secure sufficient quantities of water from those two dams if those pipelines are reconfigured as recommended by our engineers and the Water Technical Committee set up by the Minister of Water. And if one speaks to these technical people, the engineers, they will tell you that there are detailed processes that they have to go through. And so we appeal to government to release that money as urgently as possible. We also have our medium-term plans, and as we will discuss, I'm sure, today, the medium-term plan
on glass block is progressing well. The town clerk and his management team have had very productive meetings with the consortium, and we are in the final stages of our management team and the consortium agreeing on the water purchase agreement, the legal agreement that will facilitate that. And we look forward to Zeda and Zinwa giving the necessary authorities and support. Since we last met, I've also, with the town clerk, had a very productive meeting with senior government ministers and, I beg your pardon, senior government permanent secretaries and the like, and it appears as if government is supportive of glass block. So these are measures that we need to take as a city, both short-term and medium-term, if we are going to adequately deal with the crisis. But as we know, it goes beyond mere water. We know from the World Food Programme and from government itself that many of our children in this city are severely malnourished. The World Food Programme recently gave a statistic that 23.9% of children in Zimbabwe are severely malnourished at present. And we are not immune from that as a city. And so as we meet today, we need to meet in a very sober fashion, because our city, our nation, is in a crisis as a result of this drought, as a result of food shortages, as a result of water shortages. But I look forward to our deliberations and look forward to working constructively, as we have been, to get through this period, which we will, with God's help. Thank you. Let us now move to town clerk.
Thank you, Your Worship, councillors of the city of Bulawayo, city management, esteemed stakeholders, and ladies and gentlemen from the media. The legal question being confirmation of minutes of the ordinary meeting held on the 8th of May 2024, attached as Annex A, pages A to T. Thank you, Yoshi.
Thank you, Town Clerk. Can we have a mover for the
side?
Let's move to item two on the agenda, the report of the Future Water Supplies and Water Action Committee.
I move that the report of the Future Water Supplies and Water Action Committee, meeting held on the 7th of May 2024, is submitted, be received, and the various recommendations contained therein be adopted.
Thank you. Is there a debate? Is that a seconder?
No.
Okay. Seconded. Debate?
It's item 6. I would like to say job well done to the council rangers for being observant and the city council and the committee on the matter concerning the leach pad at Addis Farm. But though it's a matter of urgency that we need to tackle this as asset and we need a time frame on this. We need a legal framework that we should deal with this situation. We cannot allow our only source of water to be contaminated with cyanide. Let this be stored before lives are lost. Alkaline sodium cyanide solution is a dangerous chemical which can cause death. So we need this heat leach pad that the council to have a legal action on this. Thank you, Worship.
Councillor.
Lezinye indawo ngoba owakhathesi sikhuluma kanje abahlali bayahlala isikhathi sibalisela ukuthi even half a month bengatholanga amanzi. Abahlali becina bethola amanzi emgodini engavalwanga, becina bethenga amanzi kumabhawuza angasanitizwanga, angavinwanga, okuyingozi kakhulu kubahlali bakoBulawayo or nabahlali be-County Park in general. Kuzananzelelange Nkosi ukuthi i-County Park yindawo esingathi ile-water table ephansi kakhulu okwenza ukuthi kube nzima ukuthi izibhorane ezikhona zikhipha amanzi aneleyo ukusevisa izakhamuzi ze-County Park. So-ke isicelo-ke Nkosi ngesokuthi aluba ikomiti ingaprioritiza uku-improvewa kwesayizi ye-pipeline elinka i-County Park lezinye indawo ngokuzananzela Nkosi ukuthi i-County Park iyaziwa ukuthi lilokishi elesibili ubukhulu eZimbabwe yonke jikelele and currently more than half zabahlali be-County Park abatholi amanzi okuyinto eyangisayo njalo eyihluku ezakhamuzini ngoba uBulawayo seyehliswa abe engani usokuyi-village nje kuphela ngoba nxa ohamba khona ngapha langapha uthole izakhamuzi zithwele imigqomo yamanzi. Ngapha uhamba khona ngapha langapha uthole izakhamuzi zithwele amabhakede zifuna ukuthi zidinge amanzi. Okwesibili Nkosi, siyabona imizamo eyenziwa nekomiti eyokuthi amanzi abe khona koBulawayo. Kodwa-ke besicela ukuthi ikomiti leli lingagcini ekukhulumeni, ekukhulumeni ama-challenges. Ngoba Nkosi sakhumbula ukuthi kule phepha elibhalwe kusikhica mfundo Musa Parara Msemo elithi disciplining a dissident city, the case of hydropolitics in Bulawayo. Liyacaca iphepha leli ukuthi since 1982 bekule mzamo kungaba ne-drought kuba le mzamo yokuthi uBulawayo athola amanzi. And as early as 1982 kwakule dimi elingakathi into ibizwa kwakuthiwa ngu-Lake Cunningham. Kwakumele yenziwe i-duplication ye-pipeline ukuthi amanzi aye emaleni. Up to khathesi loko sikhuluma ngendaba yakhona. Ngo-2020 Nkosi uzakhumbula ukuthi kulo injiniya owalethwa nguhulumeni okuthiwa ngu-injiniya Crook laye wakhuma nama-recommendations akhe ukuthi uBulawayo kumele ayenzeni ukuthi amanzi abe khona ebantwini. And up to now we are told of challenges asikatshelwa nge-success story. And this year sitshelwa ngokuthiwa kule kuthiwa yi-ministerial committee ekhangela indaba yamanzi koBulawayo layo futhi besicela ukuthi ikomiti ingayiphelisi kuma-strategies. What we need is uBulawayo ukuthi amanzi afike ezakhamuzini ngoba kathesi we need i-disruptive thinking ukuthi solve into lezi ngoba kathezi ngomnyaka lo ka 2024 we no longer need ama excuses inkosi uzalandela njalo ukuthi umnyaka uqalisa savumelana ukuthi kuna kwakuyenziwe idamu uthi ayibhophoma ten up to kathezi lokho sithied up nge red tape ukuthi ama document awasayinelanga akasayini. I don't know ukuthi enesesidle inyanga eziyisithu lokho kulungisa ama document. So I think we are sitting on a time bomb ngendaba yamanzi. Izakhamuzi ngeke zithenge amanzi kwabhawuzi ziphinde futhi zibhadale city council. So we are shooting ourselves enyaweni nxa siloko zidileya khonokho. But secondly, izakhamuzi inkosi seziphelelwa yisiningi. Ubulawayo uzaba nama-service delivery protest amaningi kakhulu ngenxa yendaba leyi yamanzi. And therefore ngicela ukuthi ikomitee lithathe serious ama-recommendation awayenzayo. Ama excuses njengabahlali bakobulawayo njengesizalo sakobulawayo, I think abantu sebedidiwe ngawo. Ngiyabonga Nkosi.
Councillor Ndlovu.
Thank you very much, Your Worship, councillors and management. My debate concerns, totally concur with you in your opening remarks that this year is going to be a terrible year in terms of the water supply in the city because of the continued depletion of our water resources. So it has never been so important to preserve and conserve the little available water that we have now. My concern is to do with the water leaks that we see along the conveyance pipes. There are so many leaks that are happening as we speak now, and many residents are baffled as to what really is our standpoint, because when we tell them to conserve water and when they come to report water leaks along the conveyance pipes, sometimes it takes up to a week or more. So we need to really capacitate this department so that its reaction teams are able to attend to water leaks and burst in time. I was also reading in the report that there is a vehicle for a pipeline inspector, which is frequently off the road. This is item 2 under water delivery. The pipeline inspector's vehicle is always off the road, frequently off the road. And we are saying we are in a critically water shortage situation, and we need to preserve the little water that we have. So I find it unacceptable that such an important essential service vehicle can be grounded and fail to carry out its mandate. Also tied to water conveyance, I would also bring up the issue of bowsers. I read about bowsers, where it talks about that we have a total of 7 bowsers, but only 3 are functional. I find it hard to take a situation whereby we then prefer to hire bowsers when we already have got bowsers that are said to have broken down in the workshops. Fine, yes, bowsers or any truck can break down. But look, we need also to capacitate the department, prioritize, resource it so that those bowser trucks can be up and running again. Because we need to contrast and compare the cost of hiring the bowsers vis-a-vis the cost of repairing. Because when you say there is an engine problem, I don't believe that it would be the whole engine that is messed up. It would be a part of the engine. So either it could be, if it's a gearbox, it would be a component of the gearbox. So sometimes maybe we need to get down to the basics and do an inventory to find out what really is wrong with these bowser trucks. The other point regards alternative sources, that would be boreholes. I want to thank our sister partners who have come up to join Bulawayo in doing repair work in the boreholes, namely the Africa Head, which has been doing repair work on the boreholes. We're talking about alternative sources here. They have done quite commendable work, but at the same time, may I bring up the issue or concerning my ward, where this same partner, Africa Ahead, drilled a bore and left it at a stage where it cannot pump water. And now the residents of my ward have actually come in to contribute. They have actually bought 2 5,000-liter JoJo tanks to complement the city council efforts. As I speak to you, those JoJo tanks are at my house. We are complementing city council efforts. So I want to appeal to this council, particularly management, to keep their eyes wide open so that if there is a partner who wants to help us, they can then complete that borehole. My last point on this item is to buttress what Councillor Netta said, the heap leach pad that is on the catchment of Mzingwane district. I believe we should look at the broader picture as well. The land management situation in the catchment areas of all the supply dams. There is total chaos, there is lawlessness, and City Council is doing its best. I saw in the report that they are saying yes, there is confiscation of items and even the vehicles. But we need to really come strongly and make strong pronouncement. If it means inviting resident minister, minister of mines, minister of home affairs to this council, they would rather come here and we face them. Because we believe that actually managing and controlling those illegal miners is a matter that is beyond the city council's capacity to handle. Thank you.
Ngiyabonga Nkokheli. Mina ngithanda ukugada kumuca uKhansela Enindlovu asukume ngawo owamanzi. Angizukukhuluma kakhulu ngamanzi, but ngifuna ukuthi ngikhulume ngohlupho esilutholayo phakathi komuzi ngenxa yokuswelakala kwamanzi. Sodolobho, ukuswelakala kwamanzi kusinikeza uhlupho olulandelayo. Mhla amanzi ebuyile ayadabula ama supply pipes ngenxa yokuthi khonokho kuyabe kumele kutransportwe ngamanzi okunjenge west kuyabe sokomela ema pipeline. Amanzi angabuya nkosi ngepower layo ayadabula ama pipes amanzi ahlambulukileyo esiwa badalele ama imithi yokuwahlanza. Amanzi la ayachitheka nkosi okwezibanga ezinde. Kulolunye usuku engifonele phose wonke umuntu engimaziyo le power e-City Council including u-town clerk. Amanzi ayageleza nkosi ngolwesihlanu ngizakhuluma lapha ngimeleli i-ward yami ward 3. Amanzi ayadubuka nkosi ngolwesihlanu ngo-6 ntambama. Sifone kulabo esile mandate yokuxoxisana laba abanjengo town clerk lo somanjinela wamanzi. Izikhathe eziningi akula reaction sodolobho. Amanzi ayageleza ngolwesihlanu ebusuku kuse. Abulala amajurawolo abantu, adilizele amajurawolo, agebha amayadi abantu, ageleze umgqibelo wonke, ageleze insonto yonke kuze kube ngumvulo kumbe aze ahambe. Elokhe egeleza. Sikhuluma ngamanzi ahlanziweyo amalutshwane nkosi. Ngake ngathi ngidlule loBhengula West duzane lemagwegwe ngabona amanzi ahlanzekileyo agelezayo. Mhla ka 22 April ngawa reporta lawo manzi ngabhala nganika le reference. Ngidlule khona lamhlanje nkosi ngo-1 lawo manzi ayageleza lalamuhla. Ngahlanziweyo liphayiphi aphuma phansi. Sokulomgelo nkosi. Insokulendlela lapho uhamba khona lawo manzi. Amanzi ahlanziweyo. Njengo City Council sibhalela izalukazi lamaxhegwa kobulawayo sibahambise ekhoti sifuna ukurecover ama 250 $180. Kodwa silamanzi ageleze April May khathesi nguJuni lokho egeleza nkosi. Sithini? Angazi kumbe kakula equipment yokuthi abantu bayekhangela lawo manzi kumbe abantu baka City Council esibaqatshileyo bakhathele ngokwenza umsebenzi wayo. Bengicela impendulo nkosi ukuthi ngomthetho ka City Council kumele i reaction team ithathe isikhathe esingakanani ugu reacta to clean water best. Ngoba ngicabanga ukuthi under such droughts yiyo I priority kobulawayo. Nxa sizahlala mina ngile ndawo e Woodville since 2019 engaphuma amanzi. Kodwa kulenye indawo since April 27 egeleza amanzi ahlanzekileyo nkosi esifake kiwa ama chemicals esifake kiwo isikhati sabhadala izisebenzi ukuthi zihlanze lawo manzi. Kodwa amanzi lawo ayageleza sokuze kulomfula ompompozayo kunatha zonke izinto abantu sebethatha khonapho lamanzi okuya kwenza izitina zabo phambili. Ngicela ukuba kwazi njengo city council ukuthi silandu kuze sebenzele abantu yini kumbe sizohola singenzi lutho. Ngiyabonga nkosi.
Ngiyabonga nkosi. Indaba yamanzi I think nkosi kule ndawo lapho ohlala ureporta khona kuphesi lokuthi esigodini lo. Sokuyikhawa shama Honda Fit. Namanzi aclean. Next thing yakho nabe ngaphuma amazi evaliwe enkosi. So abantu laba ngingazi ukuthi baye sithini xa sesibabhalela izincwadi. Ngoba basifonela bethi councilor lapha sengile problem yamazi. Kodwa next door yami amazi ayabhoboza. Abantu bagcwele khona pana sisakwazi ukuthi lamasela sebuye ezolunguza esithi khona azokukha amazi. Sicela izinto emampompi lawa elungiswe sithi leyo ngeka January uphesi. Lo port esigodini lo yabo.
Niyabo mangosi. Nizaqala ngo item 6 okhulunywe ukhansela lana. Engingakutsho ngosi ukuthi andiwa I committee ye future water mhlaka 7 kwenkwezi 2014. Bahlala umhlangano bathola iripoti eyayivela kumanjinela ibonisa ukuthi kule leach pad endaweni ethile. Salungisa siyikomiti safisa ukuya kubona ngamehlo enyama ngankosi. Sithe sifika lapho sananzelela ukuthi umuthi lo okuthiwa ngokugezisa igolide kodwa uyitshefu ebantwini. I-distance yayo le damu kuseduze duze. Idamu okuyilo nkosi okuyisiphala sikaBulawayo esamanzi. Sase sinikela ke kumanjinela umsebenzi lo ukuthi ahambe lawo phambili kuligal team. Baye sibuzela ukuthi cebo bani esingahlenga ngayo umthwakazi. Ngoba sinanzelela ukuthi kungaba le cyclone laphana lingaphonga ndiyagcwala idamu. Itshefu liyana eyokugeza lelo golide. Ingena emanzini esizaphampa sizokulala umthwakazi. Yimsebenzi osezandleni ngilethemba ukuthi siwakusebenza umanjinela wami. Usezandleni ze legal team bazasinika iripoti ngokuhamba kwesikhathi ukuthi sebehamba kungakanani esingakhangelelanga ukuthi kungaqeda inyanga. Bese ngisithi ama leaks akhulunywe ngukansela laphana nkosi. Umsebenzi we-engineering, ikomiti lami ngizathanda ukuthi ngiyazise umkhandlu lo wekansela ukuthi thina ngasi-repay amapipe. Thina sikhangelele ngamanzi abuyayo, future water. Bese ngisithi ngithanda ukuthembisa umkhandlo njalo ukuthi konke okukhulunyiweyo ngamanzi alahlekayo, ngamanzi angafikiwe ezindaweni ezithile. Ikomiti liza kunanzelela, liza kuthatha likuhlolisise, sithembisa okungcono phambili. Ngiyabonga nkosi.
Do we move this?
No, of course.
Let's go to item 3. The report of the Health, Housing and Education Committee.
I move that the report of the Health, Housing and Education Committee meeting held on the 4th of May 2024, as submitted, be received and the various recommendations therein be adopted.
Second, I need the corner.
Councillor.
Thank you, Worship. Item 1B. We see the report of the committee that there is an improvement in refuse removal, but we have a challenge in some places that probably they are not attending to. And most of them now, they are now burning the waste outside their homes where there is those electricity lines. So I feel like they need to improve more on this refuse removal before it damages a whole lot of things. And also, can we know what happens to those people who are burning that waste? Because it's becoming a challenge. They are burning it at any time, anyway, outside people's houses, and it's not proper.
Thank you, Worship. Mine is item 1C under waste management, investigation and enforcement.
There is a function that happened, I think, 2 weeks ago in Kumula, where we are launching the Youth Climate Action Finder. I feel that the function didn't get much coverage because this issue of climate change is a serious issue, which the city of Bulawayo also need to be engaged on seriously to make sure that it tightly or give some initiatives towards making sure that the climate is preserved. If you look recently, the Qatar airline from Doha to Dublin had some turbulences and 12 people were injured, and I think one person was injured. And the same someone was telling me that when they were landing at Joshua Mkabogo, they also experienced some turbulences. So climate change is a real issue, and it has to be taken seriously. First, I would like to thank you, Worship, for the initiative that you engaged with our partners, Bloomberg Philanthropy. And second, I would like to urge the media to take the initiative very seriously and publicize it to all the corners of Bulawayo, so that all of our children who are supposed to get this funding, they participate, so that firstly they benefit. Secondly, they are aware of this climate change phenomenon, which has become a serious issue to the entire world. Then my last contribution will be for us as the city of Bulawayo to aid on this section, the climate initiative, so that we get reports each time when we are coming to council, so that we start talking about the climate issues. Because honestly, where we are living, if you fail to incorporate this important subject, we'll be shooting ourselves in the foot, and you won't be focusing for the future. So let's be proactive and make sure that we incorporate the climate issues going forward. I don't know whether they will be incorporated under health and housing or under environmental department, but going forward, we like to see such reports and start debating and contributing to us. Thank you.
Councillor?
Item 1B and C. But overall, allow me, Your Worship, to wish of Bulawayo, the councillors, the management, the kings and queens of Kontu to a happy belated Bulawayo Day. I'm rising on item 1B and C. My case, Your Worship, is basically on enforcement. I think we are on the 10th month since our term began as this council. Up to date, I still have a question on how long does this council take to enforce every resolution that we do in this house? In my own observation, Your Worship, let me state this without any fear or favor or any sense of ambiguity. I feel like there's a serious sabotage happening in this house. If it's not sabotage, then there's serious incompetence which needs to be addressed, maybe by your office. We stated very clear, Your Worship, if you remember very well, on refuse removal and the waste management and enforcement, etc. We gave plethora of resolutions, one of it being business community to purchase bins so that the people of Bulawayo they can find means and places to dump easily. The other one, your worship, being this department must increase the sweepers, community sweepers, those who assist us in the community to pick easy villages. Up to date, we still find excuses to say they are still doing a work study. My question is, this is the sixth month since this resolution was passed here. How long does this council take to implement its resolution? The residents of Bulawayo must know. And we must understand, us as the councillors, whose vision are we running with? Mm-hmm. Is this management and is town clerk understand the vision that we have, us as the council of Bulawayo? You came with a noble idea of cleaning Bulawayo. But what we are witnessing in the communities and even in the CBD, whatever that is written here is lies. The CPT is continuing to be very much dead. Nothing is being done. No law is being enforced. It's shocking that for this past month, we find them arresting 11 people who dump illegal. It shows that this management, it doesn't understand the direction we want to take as this council, or else they're incompetent. We cannot be sitting here in the comfort of our time and intelligence, passing resolutions for this city to be paid, for the people of Bulawayo to benefit from our service delivery. Yet we have a management, we have a task and a role to enforce the law. They sit in the comfort of their offices, chewing taxpayers' money and not delivering to the services. It's high time the people of Bulawayo know that we have a crisis within the house. 6 months down the line, these are simple resolutions. Write a policy, implement it. The business committee has a mandate to help us in those areas to purchase bins. Do a work study which doesn't take even a week. Increase the sweepers in the communities, because we are not just doing that thing for the purposes of employment only. We are doing that thing to manage environment. Councillor Moyo simply explained about the issues of climate change. What does it speak to the cleanliness of the environment? So we cannot be sitting here, your worship, Senate, discussing issues. I feel like we're being undermined. This power, the power of this house is being undermined. Mm-hmm. And it's high time your office, your worship, to be put to charge, to give a directive and put to order the office of the town clerk and its management. Failure to do so, I tell you, your worship, it's about to come, and the people of Bulawayo are not happy with the conduct. And they must know that we pass resolutions here, but there are people who sit at the comfort of their offices and not implement. And it's worrisome. Yabo.
Thank you, worship. This reception item one, I want to start by commending this section, because the very fact that every week there is a council track that crisscrosses all the roads in all the wards speaks to an attempt by the management to enable the refuse collection. But I want to look at this thing from a different angle. I think the biggest tragedy that we have in Bulawayo is a mindset and culture change that needs to be calculated within the residents of Bulawayo. If you go out there into the suburbs, you see mounds, you see piles, you see mountains of litter that has been dumped. Yet every week, every day of the week, the council trucks makes the rounds to collect the litter. Why do we continue to have people who dump litter when the refuse truck does its assignment every week? I think I want to look at this one to say, every councillor in their monthly feedback meetings, we need to make sure that this should be an agenda item. You know, building up to
the Clean Up Bulawayo campaign, which you launched, Your Worship. We need to ensure that people are educated, are reminded, are taught about the need for them to place litter in a bin. Otherwise, when it comes to refuse removal and claiming back the Sunshine City status, is not a dream that is very far from reach. We can restore Bulawayo to its Sunshine City status. It's a question of us education, educating the people, doing awareness raising so that people can realize. Because the issue of bins, I concur with my colleagues. The bins are there. It's not that the bins are not there. Yes, they may not be adequate, but the bins are there. And half the time you see a resident eating up a banana and throwing the remains on the ground. People drink a bottle of drink and they throw the plastic bottle on the ground. So we need to really zero on the mindset and the culture change. Thank you very
much. Ekhulunywe ngukansela Meli Moyo eye work study le edithemena ukuthi iwadi le wadi ithola abantu abangaki. Angazumbe iwork study le yayenziwa iconsultant kumbe yayenziwa ngama employees e city council. But nxa yayenziwa ngama employees e city council, then sile problem enkulu okudlula le sicabanga ukuthi silayo. Ngoba mina ewadini yami abantu behliswa from abantu abangu 10 baba yi 8, but those that are privy with the geographical location and the area and how sparse ward 3 specifically Woodville Park, Woodville North, Kilani, Mahachula, Lower Nondweni, Willsgrove is, honestly you cannot have someone who does a report, a research, that does not include the councillor of the place, number one. Number two, you have a study that looks at a place that starts from Nast, which on its length across it is around 21 kilometers. You reduce sweepers from 10, which is not adequate, to 8. On the basis of a research. I want to understand, number one, what formula was used to arrive at that number, and which school taught these people that did the research to go and do such a research which does not speak to the reality on the ground. We sit here as councillors to come and make decisions that are going to assist the thing. When you make these statistics that direct you to making wrong decisions, you phone us every day from city council. Councillor Masham, you are the Akwingolile. Niye iklina yini management ye city council mini yani. Ngoba liya reduce abantu. Ake ngitshele ukuthi umuntu oyedwa njengoba bengu 8, umuntu ozadobha izibe nasty, ufika nini egroundini yekhilani old school of old Nick. Umuntu ozadobha from old Nick usuka nini ukuyathatha ukuyadobha izibi kosompisi emahathula bese siye Willsgrove abese siya eWoodville Park okule yade yi1 eyi 4000 square meters ilanga liyachona umuntu oyi1 walking past 3 yards edobha amaphepha, and here is a study that then says kipana abantu laba bangu 10 babe ngu 8 thina sifuna more. Angwazi worship ukuthi i study ze city council is informa ikuyini yi knowledge kumbe kusetshenzwa ngenhliziyo. Sicela ukuthi nxa si serious ngobulawayo, okokuqala senze i study e involve u councillor wendawo. Mina ngike ngahambise enyi department ye city council ngilama problems e Woodville. Respectfully, I would not mention the department, but they did not know Woodville North. And they are the people who are supposed to offer service to Woodville North. But bona thina kasikwazi sicabanga ukuthi uBulawayo uphelela lapha.
siyamanga ukuthi kulenye community ngale. And that community has not been serviced in amanzi ngemigwaqo for the past 20 years. Nge city councilor abantu who are drawing salaries from the hard end rate payers. Esiba batalela amabhilo ukuthi bahambe sifuna ukubahambisa ejele ngama-$160. But these people are drawing salaries from city council who are not even privy, your worship, with the holistic geographical map of Bulawayo. And they are the city managers and directors. How do you obtain a situation where you have people who don't know the boundaries of Bulawayo and they are supposed to offer services to the people?
Thank you.
Thank you,
Pastor.
Finish.
Thank you,
thank you very much, Yoshi. Put a similar item, Yoshi. I just want to say to my colleagues, welcome to BCC. And I like which is gathering. When the policies are formulated, Yoshi, when we formulate policies, we expect them to be implemented. Non-implementation of a policy carries a charge, Yoshi. And they say everything rises and falls on leadership. When we talk of leadership, we are talking about your office and our offices as councillors, that we are failing to deliver. Mina ngangitshele ngkosi ukuthi emsebenzini wami ubhosi ngahlala la lami nganyathela phansi and exert the pressure what? Downwards. Town clerk, crack the whip. Policies must be implemented not only on health. There are quite a number of resolutions which we have implemented some long way back. They've never been implemented. You are the chief accounting officer of the city and you are in charge on making sure that the directors under here, they perform. The days of honeymoon are over, colleagues. We need to crack the whip so that residents get proper service delivered. Thank you.
Who statistics about littering and dumping fines. When you serve in your worship, so need. Okutsho ukuthi amafayindi esiwathola abantu belahle izibi 7 kuphela koBulawayo. Ama-councillors ngezigaba ngezigaba athwala nzima eclean ama-ward phose kabili kumbeni kathathu ngenyanga. Siqeda ukuklina abantu bayadampa. Ebusuku bakhona bayadampa izibi. Mzamo bani ngabantu laba badamba izimi ukuthi bebothi ngoba nxa amafayindi lisinika 7 kuphela kutsho ukuthi akulamthetho okhona obopha abantu laba abasidaphela izibi isuku zonke. Ungahamba kulo Bhemula Street lapha usiyafika ko-OK lapha izibi zakubingeleli uswelele ndawo ukuthi ungahamba njani. Ngabantu abadampa sibakhanyile sichela umthetho ozabopha abantu laba badamba izibi kube yifayindi. Yokuthi umuntu vele angekazi adampa izibi. Izibi siyazama imizamo yonke yokuthi sizikhiphe. Kodwa kusasa kuvuka kunezibi. Sifuna uBulawayo ohlanzekileyo. Asizameni ukuthi abantu kababotshwe kube nemithetho ofayindisa abantu. Umuntu afayinde simbone ukuthi ubeni ufayinda $50 or $500 ebuhlungu kaphinda lahle izibi. Sifuna uBulawayo ohlanzekileyo. Sele kube nemithetho efayindisa abantu kanzima. Singeze ukuthi abantu bazafayindiswa $50 or $500 kodwa kungafayindiswa muntu. Sibone umuntu kube example ukuthi nangomuntu ufayindisa imali engaka. Kwenzeka ukuthi abantu bengalahli nzima. Sigcine uBulawayo ehlanzekile. Ngiyabonga. Hlonitshwa.
Ngiyabonga Johanna. Umama esekhulumile. Mina befuna ukungezelela njalo Hlonitshwa. Lava abaklinayo bakithi ibe niwazwa ngendlela kama wadi abakhulu ngayo but ama salaries abo wona uvele manane ndaba wazi wabathi fomu abale khambisayo ngale lesiyani khaba tshela ukuthi bengabhali iamount but now so kuna lapho usethusa why ukabhala iamount uhambisa ifomu isada ibhalwa ngubani uhamba njani imali ifika njani njalo iyaphuza abantu labangasithwala nzima sibancenge size sibathenge noma nje ukuthi behambe emsebenzini inkosi abantu labana balezimuli bakhangelela ukuthi bavukile balabo bachiyo babo ezindlini bakhangelela ukuthi bavukile baye emsebenzini abantwana baye esikolo labo bafuna ukubakwazi ama-salaries abo abuya in time ukuthi khona labo bekwanise ukunakekela imuli zabo njalo cela sibengezelelwe umholo wabo uyaziwa ukuthi imalini ngiyabona.
I remember on one of our previous council meetings, I made the recommendation of Hyde Park being
fenced or something. And I thought this report will also include on how far they have decided or they have done on the fencing of Hyde Park. Because the situation there is not nice, also. I wish maybe councillors should also go there and see how kids are playing on top of graveyards every day, on a single day. Can at least get something about this issue, even if they can fence one side where they divide the house and the cement.
Mm-hmm.
The item 18 and 14. Your worship, I would want to congratulate the committee for reopening Ikwezi Vocational Training College. I understand that Ikwezi is now a hotel and a school, and therefore we congratulate the department. But however, I think that it's important that we increase the enrollment at our city council-owned vocational training colleges. What is clear, Your Worship, is that there is a high demand for vocational skills by residents of Bulawayo. If you look at the number of people who queued up to enroll in Chaka Youth Center, at Sizinda Vocational Training College, and so on, you will see that there is a huge demand for these skills at these vocational training centers. And therefore, I think I would implore the committee to expand vocational training colleges in Bulawayo, particularly in new suburbs such as County Park, Umla South, and Emganwini. Maybe they may have to consider setting up satellite schools or satellite centers in new suburbs because the demand is very high. But unfortunately, the enrollment is very low, and we need to address that as a city. On item 14, Your Worship, last month, as I was touring various schools in my ward, I came across a number of learners fainting because of hunger. And therefore, I think this will be a phenomenon which is going to increase throughout the year because we do have what we call El Niño induced drought. And even poverty is going to increase. Maybe we need to then task the committee to consider mobilizing more resources to improve our school feeding schemes, particularly in peri-urban schools and high-density schools, because even poverty is real, and the kids or learners are actually collapsing in classes. And this is increasing absenteeism, and students are no longer able to focus because of hunger. And therefore, I would implore the committee to consider mobilizing more resources to ensure that each and every learner at our council-owned school or at a council-run school has at least one oatmeal a day. And I think it will go a long way in improving the pass rate in this city. Lastly, I would want to congratulate our city council-owned schools for excelling at the dramaturgy competitions which were held at the recently ended ZITF. I note that our schools excelled and we were number one in 4 out of 5 categories. And that is a very big source of excitement as a city. I thank you.
Given that we've exhausted the debate, I now wish to contribute to it before I call on the chair to respond. Much in the same way as the debate around the water situation, this is a multifaceted problem, and it's not easy of quick resolution. I'm talking about the need to clean our city. I've heard the complaints of some councillors against the management. In some respects, that may be justified. But I think in these debates and for the public, it is critically important that we provide balance to the public and that we stick with the truth of the matter. My own experience is that many, indeed most of our employees are working exceptionally hard. They are dealing with an overwhelming amount of rubbish which is being deposited every year, every day, every week. We have limited numbers of refuse vehicles. We have limited numbers of bins. We have a major problem at Ngozi Mine, which needs resolution. And we can't place all of that on management. My own personal experience with, for example, the superintendent of cleansing is that he and his team work exceptionally hard and try to respond to complaints. It may be, of course, that there are other departments, other people who are not working hard. But the point I'm trying to convey, particularly given the fact that the public are listening to this debate, is that we recognize that not everything can be laid on the council. We have a psychological problem in our city. The one councillor touched on it. Until we educate, until we change the culture of our citizens to stop dumping in the way that they are doing littering, it doesn't matter how efficient, how many refuse trucks we've got, we will battle to deal with the problem. It also, one councillor spoke about leadership. And the leadership has to start with ourselves, each one of us. And I want to put out a challenge to councillors. I've been privileged to be invited, I have to say, by some lady councillors to tidy up their wards with them. They demonstrated leadership in that regard. They set a new standard themselves, personally. They led by example. And I challenge every single councillor here in your 29 wards and the PR councillors to, at the very least, have one day a month where we are leading from the front and trying to clean up our own wards. And demonstrating that we as leaders are concerned about this. To continue, tied into this, Councillor Moir mentioned the Youth Action Climate Change. We must see this as a starting point. It is a small amount of money that has been donated to the council, 50,000 US. But I urge councillors now to go out, particularly to your young people. This fund is open to youth between the age of 15 and 24. They've got up until the 1st of July to devise projects for climate change action policies and programs. Please be energized in your respective wards to ensure that youths in your wards know about this fund because I see it as the start to transforming the way we view our city, so that we start taking pride in our city now. I want to, before I move on, I'm not dismissing what the councillor's criticisms are. You need to understand that. And I'm sure that the town clerk will take that very seriously. Our workers must work as hard as they can. They must be diligent. But it's a combination. Let me also end by referring to item 15, which speaks about the waste management facility. And I urge councillors to think outside of the box. We need urgently to proceed with the waste management program. You'll see from the minutes that the town clerk has advised that council is about to award a contract. We must get engaged. We need to understand what that contract is, what it entails, the companies that are going to be involved in this. We must have no scandal around this. It must be done, and the contract must be awarded to the most efficient company. We don't want to have the scandal in our city council, which has attached to Harare in the allocation of these contracts. In addition, we need to pursue what other remedies we can to ensure that we clean up the city. But we need to recognize that this is a holistic, we are only going to achieve this through teamwork. Chair, if you'd like to respond.
Ngiyabonga Nkosi. Ngizaphendula njengomsekeli kamgcini sihlalo wecommittee. Ngibonga imbono ukunanzelela kwabosodolobho izinkinga ezisedolobheni lethu. Okokuqala, ngithanda ukulihalelisa ngoba uBulawayo useneminyaka elikhulu lamachumi amathathu, okubonisa ukuthi idolobho lethu selikhulile. Le nhlupho elikhala ngazo engicelayo ukuthi osodolobho akumelanga likhale, kumele njalo lisitshele amanye ama-solutions ukuthi belifisa simbambe njani, ngoba yikho abadala abasithuma khona. Ngizathanda ukuphendula kulokho okunye inkosi siphendulile. Kube nombono wokuthi sifake ucingo emangcwabeni ase-Hyde Park. Nxa ngathi lingahambela khona phana linanzelele ucingo lukhona phakathi kwafakwa le-hedge. Ucingo olunye lwajonjwa. Ukuthi lwajonjwa ngubani asazi, kodwa kudinga thina njengabakhokheli ukuthi siqale sifundise izakhamizi zethu ukuthi singafaka impahla zethu sizigcine. Sizawukhangela umbono sibone ukuthi sizawusebenzisa kanjani. Bakhulumile ngama-resolution okubana amankampani sathi abe lamabhimu. Izolo lokhu besisamukela amabhimu avela ku-Alcom, ulawo weyakhe inkampani uphinde wasinikeza silidolobho. Kuyisifongo leso kutshengisela ukuthi kukhona okwenzakalayo. Sizalinikeza i-detailed report ku-next council meeting. Kuthi njalo abaningi abazwisisanga kakhulu ukuthi i-delimitation le work study. Njengoba idolobho leli ngishilo ukuthi selile iminyaka emingakanani. La bantu abaphakathi kwalo bangakanani. La ngendlela futhi abaziphatha ngayo. Ubuntu bethu abusekho. Kusadinga kuqala ukubana thina njengoba basithemba basikhetha ukuthi sikhulumisane labo ukwenzela ukuthi sitshintshe i-mindset. Ngoba ukungcola kukaBulawayo kuqala kithi abakhokheli singakahambi kubo abadala. Maybe thina senze umsebenzi abasikhethela wona ukuthi sibafundise. Singananzelela labo abantu abaqhatshiweyo kule ndlela esasikhangeleyo ukuthi bancedisa ukhansil ukuthi badobhe khona amaphepha. Abadobhi door to door. Kule migwaqo ekhethiweyo eyayisiya lapho esithenga khona esithi esitolo. Le ndawo kuhamba khona sisiya kuma-police station ama-main road. Yikho lapho esasikhangele ukuthi basikhangelela okuhamba khona abantu. Sasa ngakhangela ukuthi bahamba ngumuzi ngumuzi kumbeni ngendlu. Ngakho siyayithatha imbono yenu njengoba uBulawayo sekhulile njalo ingcikeza isandla. Sizabuya sikhangele ngoba i-delimitation ayizange ingezelele izindlu. Yatshintsha kuphela ukuthi iwadi yangezelelwa enye kwakhitshwa kodwa yasala lokhu ingubulawayo injengoba ibinjani. Ngakho sizayithatha imbono yenu. Bake bayenze i-workstudy bangezelela kodwa ngengcikeza ekhona. Njengoba usodolobho sekhulumile ukubana kudinga thina ukuthi sifundise uBulawayo ukuthi sigcine njani uBulawayo ukuthi ahlanzeke njani kuqala kithi abakhokheli. Ngibe sengiqhubeka njalo ukhansela ukhulume kabanzi ngokutshintsha komkhathi. Wakhuluma neprogram yayethwa ngusodolobho elanda untanga esithemba izasincedisa imbono emitsha evela kubontanga ezancedisa ukuthi uBulawayo athuthuke. Yikho sikhangelele ukuthi lingeni libazise ontanga imawadi ukwenza sisinikiseke ngama-new ideas azanceda ukuthi uBulawayo njengoba ehlaselwe yokutshintsha komkhathi kusebenzele koBulawayo. Akunye bendibuka imisebenzi njalo siyavuma ukuthi kulalapho esingabe sisehluleka khona. Sizazama ukudonsa amasokisi, sizame ukuthi sikhuphule izinga esisebenza ngakhona. Siyabonga kakhulu.
I would like to thank you all for the contributions and the pertinent issues which were raised. I think they are going to help us a lot. And as my colleague has already alluded to some of the issues, I believe we're supposed to complement each other with the various ideas which can take us further as a department. There was an issue of refuse removal. I understand each and every week there is there are trucks which are collecting a refuse from various wards. Unless if there are some complications or breakdown. I think your worship has already alluded to the issue of resources. As city fathers and mothers, let us always consider that we are lagging behind because of lack of resources. We might be excelling maybe by more than 50% compared to what we are doing, but we are lagging behind because of lack of resources. I think we all know that our residents are not religiously paying their rates. Even some of us as city fathers and mothers, we owe our local authority a lot, and that has great effect in service delivery. To our employees, though they might be doing their best, I would like to applaud them to some point, because our local authority employees are least paid employees. Go to corporate, go to private sectors, even government civil servants are paid far much more than our employees. Our employees are yearning far much more than the poverty datum line. So as we really demand results, let's think about their welfare as well. We are taking everything as a concern, and we hope to address each and every concern. But my plea is that let us work together, hand in hand, in order to come out of this crisis, especially the economical crisis. Thank you.
The report on the Environmental Management and Engineering Services Committee.
Thank you. I move that the report of the Environmental Management Engineering Services Committee meeting held on the 20th of May 2024, as submitted, be received, and the various recommendations contained therefore therein be adopted.
Thank you. Debate? Council.
Item 3 on sewer.
What have you got, ma'am?
Item 2.
Thank you, Your Worship. I am rising as item 2, water distribution. As a councillor for Ward 2, which includes, among other areas, Trinance, we have a similar concern where high-lying areas are affected in terms of water supply, and they are more often than not found in a situation where their taps are dry most of the time. Where other areas receive water, they do not receive water. I think it is time for the department to consider innovation and disruptive thinking to see how best such areas can be serviced so that they can also receive water, because at this juncture they feel like they are no longer part of the city, they feel like orphans, they feel neglected. And as their representative, I'm here to express that sadness, that disheartenment which they are collectively going through as a residential space. And I want to implore and urge the department to look into these matters and give them due consideration. I thank you.
What item, man?
It's item 2.
What is item
3? Item 2.
Item 2.
Thank you, Worship. I think maybe in Paravina, I want to write on the Kansela Umoe. What you said is very imperative. You need to take it serious, because as a city, you can't say there are certain areas that are not receiving water, and they are saying that only the island areas. In Sibu, you are saying they should be restarted so that there are some sections where the valves should be closed for those light areas. Then you divert maybe a route that enables the island area to receive water, while if you are closing the areas which are on the low side, so that everyone gets water. So it can be similar, Your Worship, so that it's clear, because you talked about disrupting and innovative, maybe when they didn't conceptualize it. But now, let's have a start. Amanzi fee, small locus, Amanzi fee, because those areas are highlighted. Thank you.
Yes, item B on sewer. I recall the worship that 4 months ago I raised this issue on the sewer itself, and an answer was given that
the department is seized with the bringing in contractors and so that they will come and fix such. My question is that how far have you gone in trying to resolve such? Because Iskatsia Hamba, we are not seeing any changes. So, Chairperson, may you please enlighten us in that regard. Thank you.
Okay.
Can't we have a permanent solution? Kuma sewer based. Because Emma Kokova, that person is not what saved this. I always report his teachers to Willie. But we are not traveling with his teach. Today, the Bahama baby is here. Some says it to Willie. What exactly is the problem? Because I can't be reporting every day. So I best, same stitch, so I best, daily, same thing. What is stitches to Boogie? Zamova is a cancer, Woody, Bengalunis, a good side is Nina, who are to Boga. We know as Woody always is stitches to Boog. The loon is as sad as it to Boog.
Thank you. Item?
Item 3.
3.
Mobi Pumula says Paradu Masua and Zima. Siribodan Suzongang, less 7 years. I think so, 6 years. Cut, I'm talking Angan, who can say Nikuluma is the same problem. Ipam station, I say it. Abakuma, among his teachers, a mammy, woman, Tina's coming a pump station, Utabula Lapoya, no Pumula North. So Abantu Shell Paradu in Gaze with whom? So William Motors, the 12 child. Near Kumbula says at Donetelo. Nye organization, nizwe utu ifili. Mkosi ngotu pesi lalu, gambe, alingege libe la makinga, oguti li nanzele, luguti li akangeliti ngesikate singari vigi pelile, li habele etus. Mwaba kusifana luguti sebenza maple toilet. Mwabi pump station nga inga sebenza, kula ndwe sebenza. Njalo sinanzele la luguti, awa sebenza, yubaya sile li moti yotu kichimama logi chamanengi. Kambe sizatsheli zakhamizi nsuku zonke kuze kube nini. Kanti kunani ukuthi sike sithi sikhangile ukuthi kuthengwe nje ezimbili ngoba amasuwa yinkinga. Sibone ukuthi Bulawayo uyancediseka. Chalman.
What item, ma'am? What item? 3?
Item 2. So item 2 is 1.
2.
Yes. Ngiyabonga bose. Ithube ngitholileyo. Mina ku-item 2 ngizile uthea ekhuluma ukubana hhayi kuzolungiswa. Kodwa isikhalazo sami silapha nkosi. Ngike ngabika phambilini ukubana ewadini lapha engikhona abadala sebeze bemba imigodi ngenxa yohlupho lamanzi. Imigodi engikhuluma ngayo nkosi kayimanga kahle. Ngoba kathesi ngikhuluma kanje isichonile lokho bezama ukuthi bethola amanzi kungangukuthi nxa kungaba nomuntu owelayo ingozi yobuhlungu nibe sensithi inkosi icela lingivumile ngihle ngibambanise lo item 3 uitem 3 iso nilesifula kulesifula ewardini sengivikile inkosi. Kodwa ukhanya imizamo yokuncedisa ayikho laphana. Abadala nezingane ngibona kuba sengozini embi. Ngoba kuba lesikhathi sokuthi kube lomoya. Umnukolwana uphakama ngamandla usiya empilweni zabantu. Angazi ukuthi kungalungiswa njani khona phana. Ngibe sensiya kulezigaba ezikhona phakathi kwewadi. Ezigabeni lezo ngiyabika bangalungisa lamuhla kuyahlala bangalungisa la kuyahamba kuyevuleka kwenye indawo ongangukuthi sokuyinto ehlala ikhona esigabeni angazi ukuthi ngingaphathiswa kanjani izakhamuzi ziphathiseke
ngoba sezisesaba seziphile ekwesabini ngibe sengithi ngihle ngikubambe kanye bonke ngivumelanini ngihle ngibambe lo daba leluvevesi lomgwaqo weluvevesemitri ukubana sokubuyele njalo amagodigodi lawana okungawukuthi othuleyo nxa esiyalala ngale angazi njalo kumbe ngoba kabavuli amabhokisi sebefikile kumbe njalo uyabe sejibilikile ngoba amagodi lana aseqalile njalo angazi ukuthi mizamo bani engenziwa ukubana umgwaqolwana ulungiseke katsha bephinde njalo ukugqiba inhlabathi ngiyabona.
Still on item two, Your Worship. I'm looking at the tab whereby they are talking, the report is talking of the attended leaks and the outstanding ones. I think this is worrisome, Your Worship, because the number of the outstanding leaks is just too much. So I think as a council, can we find out the challenges that are stopping these leaks to be attended fully so that probably we can help each other on how we can actually speed the reaction or speed the implementation. Because if we can have the money having 324 leaks which are outstanding and only 51 have been at only 19 have been attended to. I think we are not doing something properly there. We need to actually come up with ways of how we can deal with these outstanding needs. Thank you.
Councillor, I don't want to disrupt the debate, but
once again, I come back to the point I made in my earlier comments. We're dealing with a water distribution system that is over 40 years old. It has not been maintained for some 40 years. It is inevitable that we are going to have a high number of leaks. That is now compounded by the drought and the shortage of water. What I'm told by the engineers is that when water is cut off and water is resupplied, the pressure is higher than what the piping system is designed to take. It is designed to have a consistent flow of water. So whilst I'm not denying in any way that the gravity of the problem, we need to understand that there's no simple solution to this. We face a very grave crisis. Clearly, our staff have to respond, and we need to be better organized so that we respond to leaks quicker than we are doing. But also, it is important that we be honest with our electorate and explain that even with the best efforts of our engineers, because of these factors that I've spoken to, it is incredibly difficult to respond adequately. But I don't want to get involved in a debate with you because there are other people who I think want to contribute.
Thank you.
What items?
Item 3. Yeah, ngiyananzelela ukuthi indawo yamasuwa le ama-colleagues ami bakhala ngokuthi kuyabhesta, but we have a place engekho serviced vele koBulawayo i-country park okungela wona amaphayiphu nalawa abhestayo. So ngizathi mina uchairperson we-committee leyo nxa engaba le mpendulo esitshele ukuthi mzamo bani okhona so far ukuthi over 10,000 households in Cawdra Park ezingela phayiphi unongowayekambayo kule solution bani esikhangelele ukuthi mhlawumbe abantu be Country Park singabatsheli ukuthi ezubulawayo sizayenza njani. Ngiyakwazi ukuthi mhlawumbe ngempendulo emfitshane e Country Park sizaphendula ukuthi gakula mali kobulawayo. Ngibe sengizibuza ukuthi mina ngambe izindlu nxa zizinengiso yani kuyini okwalayo ukuthi ubulawayo a partner with the companies ezingakwazi ukuservice indawo leya. Gathi izindlu zonelezana kayiso enough collateral yini for us as ubulawayo to get one contractor and service the whole, that whole area. Izakhamuzi zeCountry Park kaziyali ukubhilwa for that service because bayakwazi ukuthi indawo leyana bayithola on a condition eyokuthi bazasisevisela. They are quite aware of that. But because of economy, mhlawumbe ukuthi kuseviswe ngokuphangisa bekhiphe imali ka-1 kungaba nzima. But thina ithi phela ubulawayo wakhona why singabadingeli umuntu ongaseviswa indawo leyana so that siqede indaba yokuthi kule ndawo engaseviswanga. Kuyini okunzima umhlawumbe ngizathi mina okuke wakhulunywa ngukhansela uBruce ukuthi kule supportive ngoba angiboni okungaseyalisa izubulawayo ukuthi siyenze khonokhwana ukuthi siphathine lama companies. Jera code that is there is confirming ukuthi if we give him a tender to service ngesikhathi esinalo service. Why singamvumeli service nxa ikwanisa? So many companies, so many private developers, they are servicing. Why as a council thina singa authorize that? Then we bill ama residents on alana because they need that service. Indaba yama sewage e Country Park. Last I think it was it February. We talked here, sakhuluma sathi those people are using ama play toilets. Sathi let's have ama solutions from that department. Ukuthi sibancedisa ngani abandawana ama toilet lana asegcwele. The toilets are full. But yes, Bulawayo, we have no solution to that. Ngibe sengisithi mina do we have abantu abasiqatshile yini abantu abacapable kumbe siqatshe abantu who are ignorant. So ngilethemba ukuthi from this meeting today sizaba le action ekhawudupa ngayo nxa kule mpendulo the relevant department can they come to Khawudupa and explain ukuthi ama-challenges akhona yiwaphi because sesidiniwe ngokulokho sithembisa ukuthi kuzalunga kuzalunga. So people in Country Park abasela hope ukuthi are we considering them as a Bulawayo. Thank you.
Yes. Country Park is very excellent.
Ngiyabonga mkhosi. The same item. Isura. Nambona ngani maybe izulu. Izakhamizi zindilisile ukuthi sesibuya lesigubhu sizothile ukuthi ngeda khonapho siyabuya la sizothela nga ngibone ukuthi i-situation yesuwa injani nawukhala bona ngana ama-problems esuwa ay sesikhale kakhulu it's too much. Yes, ngathi ukuthi amanzi kawakho kodwa siyacela ngoba nxa bona bathatha i-action umuntu usekhulumile efonini ukuthi sengibuye ngizoyenza izitayela khona ngapho uzabona sebebuyile all along baya behlezi khona phana. Mina ngihlala ngibatshela ama-directors ngithemba bayakwazi ukuthi umasitholi yahlupha kodwa ngizama ukuthi ngimele abantu abangikhethayo ukuthi kansela uthi sibhadalane i-service delivery yone ingabuye ebantwini. Baba Nkosi ngicela lo town clerk sikhulume le management bebuye siphume emahofisini ngokuthi sikhulume kuphela ngezinto esizibhalayo singavuyi phansi ngalo ukuze implement izinto. You are wasting our time sizohlala khona lapha ngoba abantu bahlezi edutini ngengakhuluma izulu lapha kumbe last month kumbe 2 months ngikhuluma ngokuthi nanku izinto ziyayenza indaba singakhiphi imoto yokuthi kathesi kuyathuthuma iyakwazi ukuthi namhla amanzi avuliwe emakhandeni imoto ihlali ku standby yokuthi anytime nxa kuthi kuyadubuka hliwa simoto ikhona khona ngapho ku ground than ukuthi kuthiwa imoto akayikho ngize ngacina udirector sentshela ukuthi council insimbi ziyalila ukukwana ku tunicap ngoba imoto yenu emele izothwala izinto kayikho. Let's be serious. Singazodlala angazi. Let's be serious. Ngoba mbona ngani lapha vele sizobhadalela ama-directors ukuthi athathe imali kuphila. Kumbe yikho ngingazomi ekhuluma ngesabotage ukuthi mbona ngani lapho basiyenzela ukuthi kumbe thina sisithethiswe bakithi Zulu lapho khona siyazama. Mbona ngani imali. Sabotage ikhona khona apho ku management ngoba izinto zonke siyabe sizitshela angongeke unjele ukuthi imoto akayikho kule moto eyi-1 esebenza isuka koBulawayo ukwazi ukuthi yinto vele ukuthi abantu bayakhala ngayo ngamanzi lesuka bakithi akube yi-priority yini khona ngapho lingayenza zonke izinto elingazenza kumbe like limi ukwenza zonke izinto sike sikhangele maybe imali lokuthi namhla siyangaphi siye siyekele siyethenga imoto ezaligijima phakathi kwe kwamawards ngiyabonga nkosi.
let me respond in one respect, not just to you, Councillor, but regarding the sewage issue generally. When we were first sworn in, we were taken to deep section and a variety of other sewage works. We are aware that the city has some 8 sewage works. When we came in, we were advised that the sewage works are working to something like 20% capacity. That's what we came in to office with. That was the extent of the problem. We were further advised that in the case of deep section, that is locked up in a legal dispute. The point I'm raising in this regard is that, if I understood you correctly, to talk about sabotage, it's a very serious allegation to make. Is it substantiated? Is it borne out by the fact, the factual circumstances when we took office? I come back to the point I made with Councillor Mabeza. We have inherited a city with a very seriously neglected infrastructure that goes back decades. And we will not resolve this overnight. And we certainly will not resolve it if we don't act with common purpose. It's all very well pointing fingers at different people and staff and the like. But the fact is that on sewage, for example, I have been working extensively with the town clerk, for example, in deep section, trying to resolve that legal battle. The chair is aware of that. We have made progress, for example, on Aselby. My understanding is that on Aselby, we're very close to agreeing a contract with a private contractor to sort out the Aselby sewage works. So work is happening, but we face a massive problem. And it is important that we speak to the residents of the city to say that this will not be resolved overnight, because we have inherited decades of neglect that we are now trying to address. So I would prefer that we use more constructive language going forward. We must face up to where we are responsible. And if there has been neglect or failure to do work by employees and management, we must call that out. But we must also realize that by simply pointing fingers, we're not going to resolve this. We need to understand the root of the problems and work hard to overcome them. Further debate? Sorry, Councillor. Councillor Moyer?
Thank you.
Councillor Moyer, sorry, could I just interrupt you? I
that the councillor behind you.
To item 11.
I will come to you, Councillor Moore. What?
Sorry, I'm still on the same item.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, profound, Your Worship, what you have just alluded to us.
But I think, in simple terms, councillors are talking about sewer chokes. Those sewer chokes certainly need to be attended with speed. And I think, as a council, you've got a resolution or you agreed some time back that maybe the councillors should come, should identify people who are going to assist in those sewer chokes so that the turnaround on resolving the sewer chokes is faster. Because, honestly, Your Worship, the number of sewer pays we can't copy as council because maybe of resources and manpower. But if then people from the wards are looking into their sewers on their own, it will help to address those sewer chokes within maybe an agreeable turnaround time that is manageable or is expected of. Thank you.
Thank you.
We still on item 2.
Are we progressing?
Item 3? 7?
10.
And Councillor 11? I've been liberal in allowing you to bounce around, but we do need, if we're going to get through the agenda, we go to item...
Item 10.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Worship. I'm rising on item 10, which speaks to the park section, and I want to zero in on the issue of community groups under failed management. It must be noted, Your Worship, that we had groups in our communities that were charged with the responsibility of grass cutting. After these groups had completed the tasks and done their end of the bargain, we're in June, and these groups are yet to be paid. I must say, Your Worship, that this is not only an inconvenience and an embarrassment. It is also a travesty of Himalayan proportions. It is unheard of for people to go through scenarios where they work and then they have to labor and go through a number of processes just to get what is due to them. It is my feeling that the department responsible needs to pull up its socks and wake up from the slumber that is afflicting it. Because this current situation is not only unacceptable, but it is a very blatant display of incompetence. And as a councillor representing a community group that is struggling to get its payment, I know that what I am saying resonates with the sentiments of other councillors who find themselves in an awkward situation where they have to try and explain why these funds have not been disbursed to the groups that have actually delivered the service. If you look at that component of the report, you will note that some groups actually declined re-engagement because the element of trust is gone, Your Worship. It is very difficult to continue on a contract where you have not been paid for your first month and you are then asked to continue to do the same service for the second month. So you will note that there are a number of groups that have declined to be re-engaged. And I assure you, Your Worship, that if we continue on this trajectory of negativity, very soon we will have no uptake from the community in terms of these facilities. Because when you are faced with people and they know that they've done what they were supposed to do and they want answers on why the city is yet to disperse these funds, it is not only awkward, but it is embarrassing for a city father to find himself in such a situation, explaining in a manner that justifies incompetencies and shortcomings, which should not have taken place in the first instance. So I implore you and I pray, Your Worship, through this house that the responsible department should promptly, without further delay, disperse these funds
and accompany the disbursement with a sincere apology to the affected people. I thank you.
You want 11? 10. 10.
Just it's a follow-up addition to what Councillor Moyo already alluded to. Would these people were given their pay slips or in April? And the assumption was that shortly they were going to give their money. But it becomes a very big anomaly to get a pay slip in April, then May, now it's June, without disbursement of that money. It shows a lack of transparency, and it raises a number of speculation to the residents. Even as us as councillors, we are failing to answer. It seems as if there is no accountability within our institution pertaining to that issue.
Let me just respond quickly to the councillors.
You have every right, and it's important that it be raised in a public forum like this. But we have responsibilities as councillors as well to go and literally harass the relevant department to make sure that this happens. And so, irrespective of what happens in this meeting, I implore councillors, not just on this issue, but on many of the issues that have been raised, for councillors to be more proactive to ensure that people who are badly affected like this are assisted. Thank you.
Uzawamba umuca wechumi lanye ngithanda ukuhalalisela mhlawumbe ngithi ukuchayela ihlombe ikomiti leyi ngomsebenzi eyiwenzileyo ngokungena phakathi na komuzi babone ubunzima obukhona ngithi izandla zedlula ikhanda ikubabo ngalokho kodwa ngithi kodwa ngithi Nkosi amalembu mhlawumbe izinkonzo ezigcwele phakathi nakomuzi kaBulawayo, particularly iwadi ka deputy mayor emngceleni wayo le wadi yami, which is ward 10 and ward 11, ward 8 and ward 10, ngesintu sakithi kuyinhlamba ukuthi amalembu aphephuke yonke indawo indiwo mhlawumbe kube nama structures nje angaqedakaliyo abadala bathi yikho okumisa izulu. Ningabasoli abantu labana Nkosi ngama voters ethu, ngizakhuluma ngibamele. Ngithi ngizathanda ukusola wena kakhulu Nkosi labasebenzi obakhangeleyo kobulawayo. Mhlawumbe uzavumelana lami ukuthi babili bathathu ama-councillors afana lami aphakathi nakwalowo mkhandlu abangaziyo ukuthi yindaba ikomiti ebona ngokwabiwa komhlabathi bengabaniki indawo bayesebenzela khona imisebenzi yabo yenkosi. Ngizathanda ukuthi Nkosi likuhlolisise lamalunga akho osebenza lawo. Abantu laba nxa kuvumakala kabanikwe izindawo, babe le ndawo ezisemthethweni kabazenzi. Kusenziwa ukuthi kudala kwakungenje, umhlaba uyaphenduka Nkosi. So yikho okubaletha la abakhona namhlanje. Ngiyabonga Nkosi.
Sorry. No, I'm not giving you the floor. I want to know which paragraph.
Which item?
Which item?
I just want to wrap up, Mr. Worship.
You don't have the chair, unfortunately, Councillor.
Thank you, Worship. I'm still on item 11. I'm still on item 11, open air worshiping. I would like to thank the members of the Mthwakazi Republic Party. Is doing a great job out there. Something that a council has failed to do
They are evicting these mapostories there outside. So Niza Segela u Bonoraba Kamamu u Kansu Kalazan. Town clerk, can you kindly look into the town planning department? There is a research here that they conducted. We've got 46% of these mapostories who are aware of the local authority bylaws. They understand that you have to acquire a state. Jalo, they've applied. This is according to the report. Why is the town planning department not availing land for those people? Sitles got this one, 9 months down the line, to council, nothing has happened. In your research foot, you said 23% of the people are worshipping in Country Park. Look at how Country Park is right now. There's plenty of land. Town planning department dealing up. Why can't you give people land? Last time, we town planning department, we need development. Massive, serious development. Look at Bulawayo 10 years ago. Town clerk, can you please look into the town planning department and allocate these people about my church and my stand?
Councillor.
Thank you very much, Your Worship. Just to respond, not in defense of the member of the committee.
Yes.
As the most of the things which have been raised here are very pertinent, Your Worship. We as a department, we do not shield ourselves. We carry our cross as a department.
And when you come here, may I be protected, Your Worship? Councillor Mabeza is busy submitting his submissions behind me here. We accept, Your Worship, as a department, constructive criticism, which is coming from the floor. The concerns are very genuine. However, on hotspot, on sewer, angithi ukuthi abadala bayabengabali babalile mhlawumbe kuyabe kubakhuthile ukuthi like lizwe ukuthi thina njengekomiti kathi sithini ngalokhu eliyabe likhala ngakho anti lingakhakela i-report le iyachacha kuhle inkosi ukuthi sesidedikethe umuntu oyi-one staff member to complement i-course center ngendaba yamashuwa sakhuluma njalo kureport ukuthi hayi we have engaged 4 contractors with various experts to look into our sewer hotspot. What we want this house to charge us is next time when we bring the report, where are we? So my encouragement is to the colleagues that let's see, read these reports. I'm not saying you don't read, no, but maybe it might have helped you. Thank you very much, Your Worship.
Respond, Chair, please.
I'm glad my colleague and you, Your Worship, have answered most of the concerns from our colleagues. Honestly, as you saw, Lily Kulimitreni, so, but let me again to say, what the department is doing, where so far we've Silama contractors who are working in Kulumane, Geta, and Queen's Park, they are on the ground as I speak now. Kangela Amasua based Lama Chokes Law. You would note that because of the age and the edge of the infrastructure, they may take iskatesi to do ama repairs and come up with a long lasting solution. So Stella Lisbegezele, may be patient with us. They will come to your places as well. As long as Liz is a reporter, they are going to come to your places as well. Then on the issue of pump station, we have also engaged experts from other organization and students from NAST to redesign pumping stations so that they may bypass some hindrances along the way. Then on Country Park, we are facing financial challenges, but you'd note that Country Park is a place that was imposed by the government on the city of Bulawayo. So they sent people there to build their houses without development. So we are still trying to find partners that can do the the development. I thank you.
Do we move the report? It's moved. Councillor, you slower. It's already been moved.
I
go to just copy the minister. Can we have town lands, please? Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Osh. I move that the report of the town lands and planning committee meeting held on the 21st of May 2024 is submitted. We receive and various recommendations contained therein be adopted. Thank you, Osh.
Debate? I've given you the floor, sir. Did you not want to?
You are seconding.
Oh, you're seconding. Debate?
Debate.
Councillor.
I'm on item number 34, your worship.
34? Well, let's see, is anyone before 34?
I had a debate. So,
yeah. Councillor, just sit down for a moment, please. Okay. Is there anyone who wants to debate? Is there any? Can we have some order, please? Is there anyone who wants to debate before 34? Speak now or forever hold your peace. Councillor, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Your Worship. I note that the department is engaged in a process to come up with a local development plan for CBD. But however, Your Worship, I think. The committee must be consistent in implementing its local development plans. Why am I saying this? Just recently, we read from the press that the city of Bulawayo has partnered the NRZ in coming up with a bus terminal at the railway station. I don't recall any council resolution to that effect. As far as we are concerned, we have a relationship with one terracotta to develop a Godini to be a regional and local bus terminal. And therefore, it is shocking to learn from the press that the department or the committee is engaging the National Railways of Zimbabwe to develop a bus terminal at the railway station. Your Worship, you will recall or you will know that Kuyanyanyisa Okulepulutakawira lo 4th Street, amabhasi, ama-intercity bus, ahlezi khonaphana and uyathola se-attracte ama-vendors. Uthola abantu untelayithi gas in the middle of i-pavement, kumbe fake i-price stand khonaphana. And now there is a suggestion that these buses must go to railway station. And it's not going to solve the problem that I call. It's going to actually make it even much more worse. Because what we need to do as a city, you would see Lama Best Terminal and the way about all convenient to be in Katela. And currently, as we know, or as far as we are concerned, Jama councillors, we have got a relationship, the Terracotta, to develop a bus terminal which is going to ferry abantu abaya emalokitshini abaya kwamanye amadorobho labaya ngaphandle kwelizwe. So this thing of developing another terminal i-railway station kasiyazi njengedorobho njalo kuyasiyangisa ebantwini ukuthi kahle kahle kathesi ku-relationship le-Terracotta So we relationship airways are putting in past terminal. So I will implore the committee which is a rule a delay. In fact, I think that we must resign and set aside the decision to set up another bus terminal a railway station. Yeah.
Is it the same issue, Councillor?
Yes.
Same issue? Yes.
Thank you, Your Worship. To my understanding, the Eco Dini project came about as a result of a tender process. A lot of stages were undergone and a lot was done to actually reach that end. And now the talk of NRZ being a site for a bus terminus is not only shocking, but it's also an exercise which, in my opinion, is in bad faith, because I have not seen any process, I have not seen sight of any documentation or proposals that were actually brought to the committee to pursue that endeavor. And I am sure that councillors will agree with me that we want to have a city which is orderly in both planning and design. And with that in mind, we cannot adopt the popcorn approach to doing things, where if we dream up an idea, we run with it without following due process. It is therefore imperative that this conversation about NRZ be shelved and put in on ice until such a point where a due process has been followed, and that is then brought to the committee and council for debate. In the meantime, Your Worship, I would advise that we do not even whisper about NRZ being an alternative bus terminus, because we are contractually obliged to honor our terms and our end of the bargain with respect to the Eco Dini development project, which, in all honesty, Your Worship, is also going to introduce a bus terminus, and in the long term, it will cater for inter and intra-city travel requirements for the residents of Bulawayo. So it is, in my opinion, unfortunate that we find ourselves in this position.
Okay.
And as leaders, we need to quickly remedy this situation.
Let me respond to this, because I think
this week. All three of us are new people in this council. I was equally shocked to hear that the previous council had in fact passed a resolution regarding the NRZ. So there is an extant resolution regarding NRZ. So we are bound by that resolution. It was passed by the previous council. And all that we can do regarding that is, if it is the view of this council that that resolution should be reversed, well, then we must go through the correct procedures to do so. Having said that, I think that we are all of one mind regarding Eco Dini. And as I say, I've been seized with the town clerk regarding this matter this week. We have been in discussions with Terracotta to allay their fears, to make it very clear to them that as a council, as both as councillors and as management, we are absolutely committed to Eco Dini, and we want the contracts that they have entered into with bus operators to be complied with, and the city will support those contracts. My understanding from our last discussions with Terracotta is that they understand the situation, they are happy with the assurances that have been given, and that it will not interrupt the passage of the Plan A, B, and
two and three going forward. But let me end on this note that if it is the view of this council that it's inappropriate, aside from Egodini, if it's inappropriate that we have a bus terminus at NRZ, then this must be brought to the appropriate committee so that an appropriate resolution can be passed. Is there any other debate on that issue? Okay. The report is moved.
Of course.
Right. We move to the next item. And I move the report to the General Purposes Committee held on Monday the 27th of May 2024. Any second? Any debate? We have a...
Thank you, Oshi. Unless there is someone before item 26 to debate, then debate.
23. Any takers before 23? Councillor. 20?
26,
July. No, but we're on 23.
I'm on 26.
You're on 26. So you have the floor, Councillor.
Thank you very much, Your Worship. My contribution is to do with the local economic development, where it talks about the vending bay allocations. I want to first of all commend the directors of town planning and the works department for the works that they have carried out in trying to bring sanity and order within the city. We see what has happened at Bankers and Fifth Avenue. You know, the road has been redone and the bays have been clearly marked out. But however, there appears to be a challenge when it comes to the uptake and the occupation of those bays. I don't know where the hitches or the glitches are, because it would appear that work was completed quite some time back, but the uptake seems to be slow. I would like to implore this council to make full use of the Bulawayo Informal Sector Working Group, which is in charge of all the vending associations. That is the apex body which is regulating all the traders in the city. And I think that is the platform with which to approach the deployment and the allocation of the vendors there. Anything other than that is going to brew chaos, because already there are accusations that some people are starting to behave in a manner which is being interpreted as people from a certain association, people from a certain political party, you know, all this manner of allegations that are made. So my call upon this department is to make sure that we use the vending associations working with the responsible directors so that we put paid to chaos that continues to happen in the vending sector. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Worship. I'd like to comment firstly on item 26. On item 12, I'll just pass a comment. It's a combination. I see that the comment is now so much energy and zero in passing. Approving trips specified for management purposes of efficiency, capacitation, and effectiveness. I would like to recommend that as long as the invitation is not specific on the number of people who are supposed to attend a workshop, or is not specific on the name of the person, the committee chairpersons must be involved and must be included in this trip so that they can get maybe exposure and the capacitation. If you may recall that this council has no platform to educate, though we know that you are not yet educated, but in the very core of trying to develop Bulawayo, it's very critical to capacitate the councillor. So therefore, these trips, when a manager is going for a trip, they must include the committee chairperson so that they can be exposed in certain things for the purposes of learning. On item 26, Your Worship, on governance and representation. and G1 and G3 speaks on local economic development, if I'm not mistaken. G1 and G3. We are a local government of Bulawayo. We have a social contract with the people of Bulawayo. Our identity or our ideological thrust is based on justice, freedom, and equality. On equality, Your Worship, we speak about representation, equal representation, and equal access to opportunities.
Councillor, I'm afraid I'm lost.
Yes, go to item 26, G1 and G3. Yeah. G1 on government. So I was saying, Your Worship, when we speak of equality, we speak of equal representation, we speak of equal access to opportunities. This is what guides us as this council. I was paying closely to the works and the recommendations from the committee and the works which are being done to this council, specifically focusing on men and women, which is a noble idea. But I want to represent the most disadvantaged groups that we also represent in the name of equal, inclusive representation. The young people and people living with disability. I've been noting since I became a councillor for the second time that we always speak about, we have offered 26 men this certain job, 19 women this certain job. Silence on it is silent on youth and people living with disability. As I speak right now, if you may recall, we yet and ask in the name of inclusivity that we have a communications department which is represented by someone who communicates in sign language, specifically on these meetings, because we have a cluster and a grouping of people who also want to follow what we are discussing here. But unfortunately, up to date, nothing has been done. Today, we are celebrating a beautiful day of our beautiful city, Bulawayo. But for us as young people, there's nothing to celebrate. If I may be honest, the Bulawayo we are celebrating only benefited the old Batalas and the old Mama Wetu, who had access to ama industry when Duduzatunga was still Duduzatunga. Singakatshintsha industry safaka ama church. Now there is no employment for the young people. There are no opportunities for the young people. As part of our social contract to the people, in the name of inclusive representation, what efforts must be put by this committee, specifically the general purpose? Not only focusing on passing trips and etc, focusing on the issues of governance. Number one, we had an agreement, I still remember, 90 days ago, in Kweru, where we had an action plan to say, this year we are going to focus on amending and reviewing three policies, one of it being the youth police. In my understanding, this council cannot operate outside the police. And it is with that policy that can enable some certain activities and opportunities for the young people to then be equally represented by the government that we are in today. Up to date, I have never seen a report that speaks to an attempt to amend or review that policy, the youth policy of, I think it's around 1953 or so, if I'm not mistaken, which doesn't speak to the concrete issues that young people are facing. I've never seen an attempt on any report when maybe there is a committee which is set aside, enabled by the Apex Council Act, that we set aside a committee that will look into reviewing that youth police. Up to date, nothing has been done. And it's worrisome to us as young people of Bulawayo. So we are celebrating today, but we are also mourning that the local government of Bulawayo is not recognizing, is not representing, and is not inclusive in nature. in its policies. I'm seeing the distribution of marketplaces here. It speaks of men and women. I've never seen any police attempt on Ekwodini, for example, to say out of 36 tents, 10 of them they'll be offered for the youths. I've never seen an attempt to say in our planning in terms of local economic development, this certain land will be specifically set aside for the young people in a business. I've never seen an attempt to say from the town planning department, so and so land from each and every one, this land will be set aside for the youth recreational center or the youth center or the sporting facility so that we also include our young people. So it's very worrisome to me and also a charge from today to the next time we meet again in this place. May the relevant authorities and committees look upon number one, reviewing of the youth police, not only in their offices, but making sure that they will consult every young person here in Bulawayo. We don't want an office-made police, but we want a policy which is informed by the young people of Bulawayo. So we want a review policy, that is issue number two. We want to see an attempt from the maybe HR office or others, this committee. If they are doing monthly employments, let's see also figures to say we have employed 148 women, 12 men, 5 people living with disability, and 10 young people. In that nature, so that we show the image of inclusivity, we show the image of equal representation. So ngithemba Nkosi kuzakhangelwa khonoko kuqakathekiswe because we have a mandate. I as a young person, a graduate with no employment, I represent those who are also like me and those who are in communities because of failure to access to education, because of harsh conditions of economy. So please, can you seriously consider our feelings and so consider that we are not only the now, but the future of this province. Obla, thank you.
I will very clear, very eloquent.
Any further debate? No, I will be responding to before we move, but Councillor, do you want to debate?
I see a consistent and very unappreciated way of doing things in the GP, where you are here to fire people without consulting, and we have to respond as councillors in protecting abantu. And where it matters most, you major on minors and minor on majors. You come here and present us these reports as Pewa, as Biswa management, and you never interrogate these reports in terms of how they come about and to be. Because honestly speaking, now city when a statistically G31 market spaces allocation, you are coming up with the statistics that is saying men, women, 46, 13, 27, 63, 63, 37 in proportion. Where is the youth? Where is the disabled? Where are the elderly? How much percentage of these numbers represent people living with albinism? Zinga is powerful. Go allocation less. And what is GP or whatever it's called doing about this flawsy way of coming up with with statistics? Yes. What is GP doing? Liyabelisitshela ngokuthi kulabo baba kulabo mama. Abanye abantu bazenza obaba bengomama. Abanye abantu bazenza omama bengobaba. Bangaphi la?
How do you categorize them? Can we have a statistics that speaks to what obtains on the ground? In terms of youth representation, in terms of youth with albinism, in terms of even the boys and the girls, and also give us a statistics of Ubulawayo vele yena the aggregate compounded demand of abantu abafuna ama stands bangaki bonke. Auntie, we cannot come here to listen to these cooked figures. This tell ukuthi kulabo mama bangaka labo baba bangaka. Of those men and women you are telling us, how many people in Bulawayo require stands? Kathesi kunje liyakwazi ukuthi this department is also apportioning stands to abantu abavele Harare abavuke ekuseni Harare bazofika lapha bala ma stands abathengisa kiwo kathesi. But abantu bakobulawayo abala ma stands. What system are you doing to evaluate izinto ezinikwa leadership ye city council to ensure that this is how do you have five people making decisions for Bulawayo? So silandeni singo councilor la. Asibuye city council sithunywe ngabadala lama parties ethu size represent u council ngokuqotho. Let's have statistics that feeds into the reality that obtains on the ground in course. Ngicela futhi lireyine on abantu abenza these graphs zonke on all committees bayekele ukusitshela manje.
Is there any further debate? Can we keep it short because this meeting is
on the same item?
Maybe siloko sifunda kancane kancane. IGP ichoni vele. Because mina as a councillor from Kodupani, I was elected to come and make policies and discussing our issues of Bulawayo. Then, if I come here and present something which is needed in Kodupani, then that item goes to the committee. From the committee, it goes to the GP. Are we right there? Yeah, so I want to understand what GP lay ikona in Urban Council Act. Is it there in the Urban Council Act? If it is not there, why are we bringing it? Reducing committees to five. Reducing councillors to five people. I think there's something wrong there. Because ngibona ngazani sesi deprive ama issues, because when items are coming from the committees, they come to full council. We deliberate as a house and endorse or what. What is it that is being discussed by GP alone? Only five councillors. What is it there? What is the secret there? Thank you.
Any further debates on this? Right, let me respond. Can I have order, please? Is Councillor Moyo still here? Can I see him? Let me start off by saying that regarding me personally, the issues that you raise resonate. And I say the same with Councillor McClung. The issues of young people, of women, of disabled people are critically important. And this council has an obligation to look after and pay particular attention towards people who are disadvantaged, whether they are disadvantaged because they are young and they have no prospect of a job, whether they are disadvantaged because they are single mothers, for example, and battling to raise their children, etc. So you are pushing against an open door, I'm sure, regarding all of us. I think that the point that Councillor Mashlango has said, yes, we need to go beyond the mere male and female. That sounds a logical thing, so that we can make sure that we are being fair
for these different interest groups. And I think that that's an entirely valid suggestion, and I commend it to the town clerk and management that we, in our reporting, we delve in deeper and understand better. I just want to give some encouragement, though, to councillors. You may be aware, and Councillor Ndlovu, I come to your point regarding vending sites and the number of vending sites and the like. We have been involved with the Frederick Ebert Stiftung that conducted a survey regarding vendors, and they have gone into this in great detail. They've produced an outstanding report, which is with the town clerk, which is going to be presented to all of us, which will enable us to understand much better the plight of this sector of society, of vendors in general, but in particular, the breakdown of the different vendors. Now, that report, for example, says that 64% of vendors across the city are women. And that means that in the design of markets and vending stalls, we need to take into account the interests of women, particularly single mothers that may need, for example, creches for their children, and clean water and all the other facilities that women and young children in particular need so much. The point I'm simply making, councillors, is that we are engaged with this. If I may turn to the point regarding the role of the General Purposes Committee. That is very clearly set out. For the vast majority of functions, the General Purposes Committee does not pass resolutions or have any power on, for example, the Engineering Committee's resolutions. The resolution is passed at the Engineering Committee and then it is brought here. The General Purposes Committee has no influence in that regard. So the General Purposes Committee is not this all-powerful committee. This is the most powerful committee. It is the council. So I'm not sure where your concern arises from, Councillor. In fact, the essence of the General Purposes Committee is that it is the Human Resources Committee, which no other committee deals with. Is that understood? It is the committee in essence which deals with human resources, which other committees do not deal with. So can we move the report?
Yes, please.
The report is moved. Done? Finance. Chair.
Ngiyabonga Nkosi. Ngiphakamisa ukuthi umbiko womhlangano wekomiti lezimali lentuthuko owawungumhlaka kwakungumhla zimathumi amabili nesishiyagalombili kuNkwenkwezi eminyakeni wezinkulungwane ezimbili namathumi amabili lane wamukelwe kanye nezincumo ezehlukene eziqukethe kiwo samukelwe.
Ngiyabonga. Second. Second. Can we have a seconder, please? Thank you. Any debate? No debate? Move. Yeah. Any applications for leave? Where are you going to, councillor?
Mine is a request.
Yes.
We want to meet you as councillors for 5 minutes when we back here.
Yes.
Yourself, Worship, and
Mayor. Fine. Before we go to committee.
Yeah, before we go to committees, for 5 minutes.
That's fine. But let's go to the item on the agenda. Any leave? No leave?
We are ready. Let me meet for 5 minutes.
Yes, Councillor, I've heard you. Any leave? No leave?
notices. Our meeting is closed. Thank you.